Now we are discussing the verbal. In the verbal, you have two verbal sections, each one 30 minutes, and each section has approximately 20 questions, which means some students may get 18 questions, some might get 20 or maybe 21. So two 30 minute verbal sections, score 130 to 170. That means 40 points in 1 point increments. So that's the total score for the verbal is 130 to 170, 130 to 170, 40 points. Why 40 points? Because you have two verbal sections and each question carries 1 point. So totally two verbal sections is 40 questions and points are 40. So 130 means 0, 170 is the higher, the top. So from 130 to 170, that's how it goes. And in the verbal, you have three types of questions: the reading comprehension, the text completion, and the sentence equivalence. So in one verbal section, you have 10 reading comprehension, 6 text completion, and 4 sentence equivalence, which makes it 20 questions. So coming back to the verbal, I just want to give you a clear overview. So you have two verbal sections, 30 minutes each, 130 to 170. Each question carries 1 point. And remember, no questions carry more points than each other, which means all questions are equally weighted. And interestingly, in the new pattern, you can preview and review. That means before you answer the questions, you can take a look at all the questions, which was not available in the earlier pattern. And you can answer. My recommendation is that quickly go through all the questions, and as you go through them, quickly answer those questions which you feel are easy. And keep, you can mark, there is on the screen a facility where you can mark a question and go back to that question later. And even if you do not mark, you can go back to it. The only advantage in marking is you can quickly go back to it. Well, maybe you'll save a few seconds doing that. So you can both preview and review, which means you can look at all the questions before you begin to answer them. And then even after you've answered them, you can go back to them and correct the answers. If you think the answer which you gave earlier was wrong, you can change it. This facility was not available in the earlier pattern. So that's about the verbal. You can preview and review. All questions carry equal marks, and therefore do not get stuck on a question which is difficult. Keep moving. And if you have time at the end, you can come back to that question. And the verbal section, in the earlier pattern, it used to be adaptive. Now, the questions are not adaptive, but the sections are adaptive. Which means the same thing with math also, the section is adaptive. Which means that if you do the first verbal section well, the second verbal section that you will get will be tougher. Same thing with quants. So that's about verbal, my dear friends. Now let's quickly discuss the quant section. The quant section also has two sections, 20 questions approximately, 130 to 170 points. And if you remember the entire discussion on verbal, the same thing applies in quant. You can preview and review. All questions carry equal marks, and it is section level adaptive. Now coming to the overall test, I told you it takes 3 hours 45 minutes with short breaks in between. Initial 10 minutes is for your biographical information. Next 10 minutes is the tutorial, and then you can get a verbal or a math. And let us assume that you are taking the test now. You 10 minutes is the biographical section, you finished, 1 minute break in between. Another 10 minutes is the tutorial regarding how to use the mouse and all that. 1 minute break after that. Then let us say you got verbal. After the verbal, you will get a 10 minute break. After the third section, you get a 10 minute break. Okay. Now, after this, wait a minute. We have, no. You don't get a 10 minute break after the first verbal. you get only a 1 minute break. You will get 10 minute break after three sections are over. Okay, so I correct myself. The tutorial 10 minutes is the tutorial, and the first one is the biographical 10 minutes, and verbal is the third, which is actually the verbal section, and prior to that you get the AVA. Well, here anyway the breaks are not important. You can just you can see on the tutorial. What's important for you to learn is about how this whole thing is structured. All these minor details should not really bother us now. Now, so you have verbal. You can get a verbal first or a math first, and you will get one dummy section which is called the experimental section, which means one verbal or quant will be extra. That means you will, let us say, you might end up doing three verbal and two quant, and you will not be able to detect which one of these verbals is the experimental one, and don't try. And they give you this experimental with their own research objectives. They will modify the questions for future tests, etc., etc. Nevertheless, the fact is you will get either three verbal or three quant. So if you have got two verbal and three quant, it means that one of the quants is an experimental one. At the end of the test, now this experimental can appear any time. The end of the test, at the end of the test, you can have, you might have, not all have this, you might have one more verbal or quant, which is called the research section, and this is optional. If you do not want to do that, you don't have to do that. And obviously nobody would do that in that case. So they have an incentive, they have introduced an incentive that they'll give some gift. We are not sure what that gift is. So if you are keen to, if you are keen to find out, then you can as well probably attempt that. So this is our entire discussion about the test. Hello friends, Kripa Shankar here again with you. We thank you for your interest in Kripa Coaching and studentsrunway.com. If you find our content useful, please like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and we hope you give us a plus one on Google. You can also subscribe to our email list and be notified upon new updates. Thank you. This is Kripa Shankar signing off. Good luck.